evening, commissioners. Thank you for your time and your service. And they would discuss it at that time. Upon speaking with their president, they have decided that they are going to fight the entire removal of it, even though we have proposed reducing or making any type of modifications from taking the buffer from a non-disturbable buffer to a disturbable or something that could be landscaped or modified. Their initial concern, their additional concern, excuse me, were property values, precedents, were the next two concerns that they brought up. Property values. Per the current county property tax codes and website, the GIS, current properties of Brentwood Estates are valued significantly more than those at Long Lake. So having a negative impact on Long Lake is just not feasible. Precedents. We wanted to not allow it to be removed because of precedents with their other neighboring communities and commercial properties. I can understand that about the commercial properties. However, with the residential properties, they are not at complete build out as of yet, which I can also understand. We don't want an eyesore if the developer goes under and cannot finish their development. Our development, though small, is completely built out and finished, completed. In closing, in spite of addressing the Long Lake concerns, they've taken a negative position and decided they wish to keep it as is.
Item 5, request by 14905 Hopewell Group, LLC, to amend zoning conditions placed on ZA2457 Falling Waters Incorporated, AZ130016.
Number AZ130016 is an amendment of zoning conditions located in District Number 3.
Excuse me, Nancy, I don't believe that your microphone is on.
Sorry, thank you. Case number AZ130016, amendment of zoning conditions located in District Number 3. This is a public hearing for 14905 Hopewell Group, LLC, regarding the amendment of zoning conditions and the proposed zoning conditions to be amended as shown on the screen. This property is located on the east side of Bethelview Road at the end of Bennett Parkway and was zoned CDD and R3 with a PUD overlay by the Board of Commissioners on November 13th in the year 2000. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you. Do I hear a motion to open the public hearing?
So moved.
Second. Please vote. Motion carries 5-0. Is anyone here tapped in not speaking in favor? Item 5.
Chairman, members of the Board of Commissioners, I'm Emory Lipscomb here on behalf of 14905 Hopewell Group LLC in this request for a change of zoning conditions. This property is located on Bethelview Road and it is served by Bennett Parkway, which was originally built or constructed as an industrial park with a very wide road. I think it's 30 or 32 feet wide. That was the idea for it when it was originally built. Subsequently, it was changed to a mixed use of residential and commercial. And the residential has been pretty well built out, and the commercial has not been built. And what our proposal is to convert the commercial spaces there that would be built, which could total up to 282,000 square feet with 300 parking spaces, to not exceed 61 single-family homes. That's what we're proposing. single-family homes, 61 of them. Now, approximately 16 of these would back up to property which is currently being used for commercial warehouse space there on Bethelview Road. And for those lots, they'll be detached single-family homes. No townhomes will be provided on this property. They'll be detached single-family homes. And then the remainder of the homes, which is about 45, would be detached single-family homes. The amount of traffic generated by the homes versus what would be generated if 282,000 square feet commercial space with 300 parking spaces were built, it is greatly less for what we are proposing. It is much less as one-fourth or one-fifth, if depending on what the commercial would be, but it would not be less than 50%. A 50% decrease in the amount of traffic. We'll be glad to answer any questions you might have.
Thank you, Mr. Dustin. Would anyone else like to speak in favor? Would anyone like to speak in opposition? Yes, ma'am. How many of you have to speak in opposition? Just two? Okay. Yeah. 15 minutes, 20.
Mr. Chairman, Commissioners, my name is Joan Rusek. I'm on the Board of Directors for the Bethelview Downs Homeowners Association. Last week, we had a general neighborhood meeting with Commissioner Levent and Attorney Lipscomb. A lot of our concerns were brought up at that time, and I am now going to list our concerns for this amendment. First of all, it's water resources. We want the development to meet fire flows of 750 to 1500 GPM, whichever is greater, approved by the Forsyth County Fire Department. I don't know if you know, but we had a tremendous fire in our subdivision that within a half hour burned completely down four homes. So that is a major concern. We request the City of Cumming to determine if there is adequate water for these homes. Currently, our Bethelview Downs subdivision was required to be built with pressure boosters on each water line into the home in order to pass the building code requirement to provide minimum water pressure. Our next concern is traffic input. We request that the developer install a right turn lane on Bennett Parkway exiting onto Bethelview Road upon completion and acceptance of the Bethelview Road widening process. This is to be done at the developer's expense. We have a backup of traffic at the present time, and we feel if this could be widened, it would help eliminate traffic getting on the Bethelview Road and the like. Next is the environmental impact. We would need to have a certified engineering study done by a firm other than the developer before and after construction to determine impact and risk on our lakes once the developer has flattened the land. We request a five-year, $250,000 bond. When construction was completed by Pulte, our community experienced problems for 2 years with runoff into our lakes. A settlement was reached with Pulte Corporation, and an engineer redesigned and resized these retention ponds to accommodate the runoff. The cost of this was $200,000 to have these dredged, and that was back in 2005. That's where we're coming up with the $250,000. We would require the homes in Pod A shall be not less than 2,000 square feet of heated floor space, exclusive of garages, basements, and porches. These homes shall have a density of 3 per acre. These homes shall have a frontage of minimum 20 feet with a minimum of 10 feet in between structures. structures in Pod B, which the developer shows as townhouses, shall become single-family homes with a minimum of 1,800 square feet heated and have a buffer zone of a minimum 50 feet as per the original zone application ZA2457, stating, starting from existing First Citizen Bank exit road to their new proposed road. There is no reason to knock all those trees down, because where he's proposing to put the road, there is, I believe, space to leave some of those trees up. He's saying these houses would face the back of a used car dealer and First Citizens Bank. So in order to sell them, I think it would be to his advantage to keep some of these trees up. Townhouses are not accepted, attached or unattached. Fronts of all dwellings shall consist of brick, stone, shingles, or synthetic stucco. Exterior building material shall not consist of aluminum or writing vinyl siding, which I understand now is a requirement before site counting. Mr. Bennett stated at our meeting that he would sell the lots for $50,000 each. We request that these be sold to a builder for the complete number of lots to be built on, not piece by piece. We required the developer to install sidewalks on the east side of Bennett Parkway and along one side of any road he constructs. Also, we would like to know who is the developer and who is the engineer. According to the Secretary of State's office, Contracting Engineers Incorporated is not a legally registered company in the state of Georgia. Apparently, Contracting Engineers Inc., which is a change, it's INC, not incorporated, just became a registered company today, September 5. And this is according to the Secretary of State, who has emailed us this information. The names are different. The name on our site clock is Contracting Engineers Incorporated, which is not registered with the state. In closing, I have copies of petitions, which I have asked that all of you receive a copy of, and the clerk has them, with at least 150 signatures of residents from our subdivision who are opposed to the application that was presented to you. We do not want commercial property, but we want some amendments made to the original amendment to the zone. So we request that you defer your decision on this amendment until all of these concerns have been addressed. Now, we have met just yesterday with Commissioner Levent. He is trying to work with us, but we need answers before you can make your decision. Thank you for your time, and I would appreciate it if the clerk would pass out signed petitions we have for you. Thank you,
ma'am.
Thank you.
Just briefly, as to Mr. Wintersteen's concern, the distance that we're proposing is exactly what it exists for the homes which are there, 280 or so homes that are there, 10 feet separation between. So that's the same proposal that we have here tonight. Again, Bennett Parkway, I welcome any of you to go and drive over Bennett Parkway and see if you don't think it's the widest road that we have here in the county for residential use. I think we agree that it is. So it isn't like it's a narrow road. And this happens to be a traffic segment, one of the few on Bethel View Road. And it's going to be, when the road is finished, as I understand it, that'll be a divided median there. So there'll be good access into and out of this subdivision. As far as the square footage, I don't think we have any issues with what Ms. Russell proposed as to the square footage of the homes. As far as the environmental impact, I can appreciate we've seen that sort of problem that she described occurring with lakes as they're built, but I would propose to you that the developer and the HOA there get together and work out an examination of from a certified reliable company the condition of the lake prior to any development taking place, prior to any wind disturbance taking place there, so that everyone will know what the silt measurements or whatever they would test for before the land disturbance starts. And then if the residents there, the HOA, notice that they think there's been some change, that can be measured to determine if that is the case. Certainly adequate water pressure will be required before the project can go forward. So those fire flow and other tests will have to be made, else the project could not go forward. I think that's all.
Thank you, Mr. Wilson. Anyone else like to speak in favor? Opposition?
Like to say, we are not against a residential neighborhood there. But what they came in originally was going to value our homes. So, and we just need, we know the road is wide. We need maybe, I think, 10 feet more to make it two lanes exiting so that it'll help the flow in the morning when people are trying to get to the 400. Thank you.
If I may, just to clarify that, they're referring to right at the end of Bennett Parkway where it meets Bethel, not the entire length of the road. Mr. Lipscomb may have thought they were looking about 150 feet of the right turn lane, basically.
Is this time for comment?
No, sir. Comment that we own for this one?
Yeah.
Opposition, I guess?
Yes.
Okay. We have some time left. Are you public comments or
running cars, right? Yeah.
He's with
you.
Yeah.
Okay. I'll be brief.
Yes, sir. It's fine. Yeah.
In the spirit of
it. Yeah, like 2 minutes.
First, I want to thank you for coming to our meeting the other night. That was very helpful.
But
the thing I want to say is
state your name.
Joe Smith. Smith. The entity that's trying to accomplish this change, it ought to be a zoning change, by the way, not a minute. But that entity is not licensed in the state of Georgia to create the drawings that this decision is based on. That makes it illegal. They're not. We got confirmation from the Secretary of State of Georgia that they're not licensed in Georgia. So I don't know how you can be considering their desire to change this stuff. when it's based on documents that are submitted without legal. So I guess that's the question I have. The Secretary of State says they're not licensed in Georgia, as well as, the Board of Registration for Professional Engineers also says the same thing. So it seems to me like you ought to just be saying that you got to start over and do it a different way because we can't base it on the documents that are legal. So I think that's extremely important. And I don't know which of these folks here is the person who chases down legal matters, but you really ought to check that out. So please, our neighborhood doesn't want this and it's not right. There's going to be problems with it, including a lot of furniture. But please, you know, stop this. Start it over. And let's do it right and see where it goes.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Mr. Chairman, would point out to you that the applicant is 14905 Hopewell Group, LLC. And I don't think there's any contention that they're not a validly existing corporation here in the state of Georgia. Thank you.
I'm not arguing with their legal entity. I'm arguing with the fact that the documents they're using as engineering documents were prepared by an entity that is not legal. So, you know, I'm not disputing what he said. I'm saying the evidence they're giving to accomplish what they're trying to do is inappropriate because it's based on, I don't want to say fraudulent documents, but inappropriate documents. I asked the owner of this property at our meeting with him, I asked him if it turns out that the people who prepared those documents that he had out in front of us are not licensed in the state of Georgia, would you withdraw your request? You were there. His answer was, yes. If it turns out they're not legal, I will withdraw my request. According to the state of Georgia, they're not legal. He said in the meeting that you were at, I withdraw my request if they're not legal, even if he didn't want to withdraw his request. You guys ought to just stop this because it's not legal. Not this, but the evidence they're using to try to accomplish this.
Thank you, sir.
Sure. Mr. Chairman, just if I might address.
Let's get, okay, opposition's out of time. Do we have any leftover Emory?
We have
five. Yeah. Let's get
positive. Just a clarification, Mr. Chairman. UDC does not require engineered documents for a site plan. The site plan is not an engineered document. It does not require that. It is it's a concept plan, and that's the basis by which it was submitted. And whether a company is incorporated or inc, it makes no difference whether the company is incorporated or inc. It wouldn't make any difference if there was no seal or no stamp on the document. It is a conceptual site plan, not an engineered draw, and your UDC provides that. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Nelson. Any other comments in favor? I believe the opposition is out of time. Is your comment for or against? Yes, sir. Can we give them a minute? Without exception, without 1 minute.
And I'll have to apply to both sides, of course.
Yes, sir. Emory has some more time, but we have 1 minute to both sides.
My name is Paul Batra. I live in the subdivision, Matthew subdivision. I'm a fellow professional, this gentleman engineer, and I have exception to the way he represented himself at this meeting that we all attended, and Commissioner Levin was there too. It is to mislead, which in my opinion is a major breach of public trust. He As Mr. Lipscomb was saying, under the regulations, it's not required for this to be an engineering document. But the matter of fact is, it was a actually signed document, not signed, but placed under his company logo to imply that it was an engineering document. When he was confronted with the question that, is this true or not? Are you an engineer? What is your relationship with the company that's proposing that? That's what I thought.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Lipscomb, you know, do you have any rebuttal? Sir, any other statements, Mr. Lipscomb?
Yes, sir.
Again, there is no representation in what we have submitted that these are engineered drawings, engineered plans. They're specifically denied to be engineered drawings or plans. The engineered plans will come if and when this is approved and when it's submitted for approval by the county, and when the county has approved, those will be engineered plans, and they'll have to be gone. They'll have to be abided by, and they'll be sealed by an engineer. But what has been submitted to you is a concept plan. It's not submitted as an engineered plan. None of the plans which are submitted for the zoning application or amendment to the zoning condition are engineered plans. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Lipscomb. Do I hear a motion to close the public hearing?
So moved.
Second. Now, motion to second to close. Please vote. The motion carries 5-0. Any questions from the board?
Yeah, this is to planning. What res would a 5,000 square foot lot occur under, or if this was just going to be zoned as a res 2 or 3 or 4 or 5? It's a res 6 size lot?
4 was 6,000.
And
that's what it was. Right?
I guess I need to be I'm a little unclear. This is a change because this was a PUD. Is that correct? Why it's not being a rezoning?
Amendment to the PUD is my understanding.
Started out as a PUD, so it actually has a, well, the current zoning of the other stuff is Res 3, but now we're going to be using 5,000 square foot lots according to this.
That's an old Res 3, which is like a Res 6 today.
Yeah, and 3,040 square foot lots on Pod B.
That's why they're recommending changes, and then I've helped them come up with some of those. But I will agree with you that Pod B is smaller than the rest of the neighborhood, but we've so far worked these amendments to the point that the rest of Pod A, which is the majority of it, is the same, is exactly the same as what they have now and what was zoned as the pods back when.
5,000.
Yeah, and back then, this 5,000 square foot homes also had a minimum of 1,400 square foot homes, although they ended up bigger than that. That's why they had come forward with the 2,000 square foot minimum that they'd like to see. And in Pod B, they would like to see at least 1,800 minimum, other than the 14 that they had on theirs, with the same distance between homes as they're existing today. I think Mr. Boff, that they'd probably like to see it left alone, but considering this commercial possibly coming someday, that I believe the majority, the best I could tell, the emails I received, the majority, the mass majority, what it looks like now, including the HOA coming forward, would prefer to see residential the same as what theirs is, with a similar look, if not greater than what they have. And that's what I believe we are at this moment.
So as it relates to this, what I think I heard in the opposition say is that the density that's being suggested here is okay. You want a bunch of, there's a lot of other things, but okay. All right, that's all I just want to be clear.
Yeah.
Not the fire flow. Chief, we should have sufficient fire flow. I bet if you go down there.
That's in the city of Cumming.
Sorry, that's the water is.
Mr. Chairman, it's the city of Cumming line, and I've confirmed that with Tim.
Yeah.
But my experience, it is sufficient along Bethany, yes, sir.
Thank you. have insufficient pressure on him?
We have talked to the city this week, and they are checking into that. They feed that from the backside. That our line's out on Bethelview, and we go down to the transcontinental gas line. But there is a connection there that the city has with us that they can supplement water into the subdivision. I believe it's been turned off. They're turning it back on. It's got a pressure sustaining valve. And so there is a way for them to supplement the water supply. And I know they're looking into the pressure situation. But I'll accept possibly this smaller, I believe pod B, that might be on our side of the service line. But the residential parts that have to be across the gas line would be the city's.
Well, we do have a state minimum water pressure line that we have to supply.
Mr. Chairman, also, in defense of our water departments, the fire that happened previously that is referred to a number of times, I was there that day on duty, and it was significant, but the issues weren't related to a lack of water volume. Just like that noted.
Thank you, Chief. Commissioner of District 3, Commissioner Levent, you ready to make a decision?
I'd like to make a statement, probably a motion of most public. Being that both sides here have made comments that they have additional items they'd like to hammer out and work out within the conditions. Therefore, after listening to all these comments, the public comments, I'm aware of several other issues have been raised regarding this proposal zoning condition amendment. I'm also aware that all potential zoning conditions have not yet been hammered out. Therefore, based upon UDC 8-5.5 F2, UDC 8-9.4B and 3 and A, I move that this decision on ZA 130016 be postponed for 2 weeks to September 19th. And that during this 2 week period, the application be returned to the Department of Planning and Community Development for further review and as we work through these conditions.
I have a motion. I hear a second. Motion is second. Any other discussion?
Mr. Chairman, just a clarification. I think there was a transposition. Commissioner Levent, it was AZ130016. That's just, I know that's what you meant.
Yeah, of course it is, but I said it.
You said the original one.
Sorry.
This is decision only.
This is decision only. The public hearing is closed. Yes.
We have a motion and second. Please vote. That carries 5. Item 6 has been postponed to October 3rd. Item 7 has been postponed to October 3rd. Item 8, request by John Lowen for a variance to the Unified Development Code, Table 11.2B, to allow lots 1 through 9, 13 through 15, 41 through 44, 46, 47, 52, 53, and a Gates Casperia subdivision to have front yard setbacks of 20 feet.
Yes, sir, Mr. Chairman. Case number VA 130048, John Lloyd in Commission District 1. This is a public hearing for John Lloyd regarding the variance to the Forsyth County Unified Development Code, Table 11.2B, to allow lots 1 through 9, 13 through 15, 41 through 44, 46, 47, 52, and 53 in the Gates at Castleberry subdivision to have front yard setbacks of 20 feet. The Gates at Castleberry subdivision is located on Castleberry Road and is currently zoned Res 3. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you. Is there a motion to open the public hearing?
So moved.
Have a motion second. Please vote.